Hey everyone, breakfast vlog for Tuesday the 2nd of October 2018. Standard fare, standard time, pretty gray day. It really rained last night. Winter's on the way. It's amazing how it just almost sounded like somebody just flipped a switch. Click, and everything changed. And just want to talk briefly on, I'll get to the Kavanaugh stuff because that's what I wanted to talk about today. And I was mentioned in that yesterday, but September is over, and I was all happy yesterday about that, and might have mentioned it before, but I run a group, a chair group, and we get together every Monday night, and last night there was about four of us. It was a rainy, cold night, so it wasn't that many of us, but anyway, there was four of us, and the common thread, it was amazing, it was unbelievably amazing that the common thread that we took away, all of us, and, you know, like, we have our meeting, but I hadn't seen most of these people all of September, because it just was such a bad month, but everybody could agree yesterday that September was horrible, like 100% agreement now. Talking to a person that lives like in another town, a person who's married with family, another one that's also in her second whatever with family, and myself, and all of us were absolutely commenting on the fact that there was some collective insanity going around on in September. I don't have any, there's no proof. I'm just saying how we felt and our observations of the month itself. And none of us had even spoken, I think September maybe at the beginning of the month, right around the turn, but September's busy, kids going back to school, you know, people have things to do. So the first time we had met was last night in a while, and the consensus was, yeah, glad it's over. Let's try and learn from this, you know, and what can you learn from it, you know? Well, none of us went absolutely batshit crazy, although we could identify that there was a collective insanity running around that was, that either we were getting caught up in or we were just part of. Now, I can't answer any more than that. It's over. We've identified it. So now I'm thinking, and okay, and I'll just segue into what I wanted to talk about this September collective insanity month of what has been transpiring down in Americaville. And most of what I'm doing is I'm just, you know, I listening to the testimony is egregiously painful. And so like I said before, I'm glad all of you people who are doing those videos are doing those videos, because it's painful. But anyway, what I can take away is I'm going through the comments and I'm trying to understand the psyche. What's going on in the brains? Okay, because right now we have diametrically opposed situation. We have a diametrically opposed situation right now. Absolutely, where the two bubbles of information are so far apart that there is no middle ground. There's no possibility of middle ground, because right now, like yesterday, after all the, you know, and I've been looking at things, I'm reading, oh, it's going to be great when the blue wave comes and just shows those red bastards what's going to happen. And then I go one comment down and it's, can't wait till the red wave comes and show those red whatever, you know, I got the colors mixed up, of course. But anyway, you know what I'm saying, right? So one comment will say, blue pill, red pill, blue pill, red pill. Which one are you going to take, the blue pill or the red pill? And it's funny how that is, because it seems to me that if you do take the blue pill, you're going to go back to sleep and everything's going to be the status quo. But if you take the red pill, it's going to be an unholy shit show. So I don't know what to make of it. All I can say is that there's no talking. And in order to go forward, I've mentioned this before, we have to have discourse. We must talk. We must talk. We must hash it out. Some things are painful. If you've ever been to group discussions where you're trying to sort out your life and stuff like that, and you know that you're going to get called on. So the fact that there is no talking right now and everybody's basically in an echo chamber, that's not functioning. That's not going very well right now. And I'm not here to argue the pros and cons of Kavanaugh and the victims or alleged victims or whatever, you know, because in my opinion, it could go either way. Because right now, somebody's lying. Somebody's not telling the truth. And that's what it comes down to. That's it. Now, I've heard stories on both sides, but there again, I'm not arguing the pros and cons. All I can say right now is that there's a complete disconnect. There's no talking. There's no discussion. This group's in this. He's a rapist. This group's over here. She's a lying sack of shit. Okay, so, okay, normally, in a normal society, there will be some middle ground. You know, there has to be. Or the truth come out and then it's just one area. But right now, the two bubbles of information are so far apart that there's absolutely no talking. It's absolutely no talking. And the insanity that's associated on both sides. And I'm not picking sides here, red or blue. Not picking sides, but what I'm saying is that when you read on everything and you look at what people are saying, there's an absolute disconnect. A complete shattered reality. These people are not talking. There is no discussion. And it goes into other things as well. You know, you can talk about all the what would be considered conspiracy stuff. But now it's just like, oh, they're just lumping it all together. Oh, you don't think like this? Then you're over here. And then it's the same thing on the other group saying, you don't think like there? Then you're over there. It's quite tragic. I think we're being played like suckers. I think that it is all by design for whatever reason, I believe, and this is my opinion, of course, that there's going to be some sort of regime change in America. And I don't mean like what we've been led to believe. There's going to be a shakeup. And it's going to be dramatic. And it's going to catch everybody off guard. And the thing about it is that everybody's so wound so tight right now that they already have the person, the scapegoat has already been chosen. You know, and when I say that, that it's not for, like, everybody's got their scapegoat right now. If you look at it on, if you want to talk about the Republicans, well, it's the Dems. If you want to talk about the beer drinkers, well, it's the light beer drinkers against the normal beer drinkers. You want to talk about Quebec? Well, it's the French people against the English people. You want to talk about South Africa? Well, it's the white people against the black people. You want to talk about Europe? Well, or UK? It's the Brexiters and the non-Brexiters. Are we seeing a pattern here? Are we seeing some sort of, you know, like... oh, wait. Oh, I hear it. I hear circus music. I don't sing very well, but you get my drift, right? You know, this is a circus. It's an absolute circus. You know, and all sides. And I'm not taking sides whatsoever. I'm just trying to stand back and trying to make sense of it. Because when the dum-dums are shooting each other, I don't want to fall victim and be one of the dum-dums. Sending lead downrange and not even knowing where I'm sending it. You know, so... I mean, I once again, I hope saner heads prevail. We just don't know. But it's all on us. This is all on us. You know, I can't blame anybody else. There's nobody at Walmart that's the problem. Nobody in the parking lot who cut me off are the problem. There's something else going on that's making us crazy. So with the red wave and the blue wave, I love how they said it, the red wave or the blue wave, the blue pill or the red pill. I mean, it's just... It's too funny, and what really breaks my heart, though, really, is that nobody sees it. I could be completely wrong, you know, like in my analysis, hypothesis, whatever, opinion, who cares? Just another guy on YouTube, right? But this is how I feel, and when I spoke in the group last night, and we were all together, and we were trying to hash it out, and we're trying to sort things out, because, you know, we were looking for the lifesaver, you know. When you sink, when you're drowning, you're looking for the lifesaver, and you know you're looking for it because you know you need it. You know you don't care about how you got in the water. I want that lifesaver right now, and I think that's what's going on right now, and collectively, because right now, there is a collective insane energy going around the planet. I can feel it. It's palpable. Anyway, that's all I wanted to talk about Kavanaugh. I really have no ins and outs. I have my own opinion on who I believe and whatever after pouring through everything. But there again, that's my own opinion. And who gives a rat's ass about what I think about when on, what went on in there? All I can say is from, I'm just taking from the emotion. I'm just looking at the emotion of it. Somebody's lying. Somebody's telling the truth. The two diametrically opposed sides, there's got to be a middle ground. We have to find it. Right now, there isn't. And we're in a world, if we can't communicate, we're in a world of shit. Anyway, rambling. Peace to you and yours. Hope to see you on the flip side.